Okay, Randy, show us this exercise. Now, what does this exercise do?
This exercise helps you play the same chord in different inversions with keeping minimal movement on one note.
And what is this good for helping you with?
Organ players. This is definitely something for organ cats. They can play, they can stay center in the organ. You know, you ever wonder how guys can play a million different chords and kind of
stay in one spot?
This is a good exercise for it. It's the same chord. It's a dominant chord. Sometimes it may be a straight dominant 7. Sometimes it may be a dominant, with a 9 in there. Sometimes a dominant with a 13. But the sound, it's a dominant. It's a dominant sounding chord, and which is like, paramount for church. So right. You just got like C, right?
Okay. So
you got C.
Yeah, turn up a little.
Right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right. It's major 7. Flat to 7. It comes dominant. All right. Add the 9 here. All right. And change make it first inversion, second inversion. Third inversion, we'll drop the C. All right, so we got C, dominant. Then F, we're just going to do the circle. All right, so C. F. B flat. E flat. All right, now we're going to move. A flat. D flat. We'll move again. G flat or F sharp, however you want to call it. Then B. Then E. Then A. We'll move again. D. We'll keep our hand on F sharp, sorry. D. Alright. Then G. And back to C. Alright, so C. F. B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, B, E, A, D, G, and then C. So if you're playing organ, you just play like this. Sorry. With your foot. Mm-hmm. So that's basically it, man.
Right. Hey, answer me a musical question. There's something, I'm just throwing this out there. There's something that I noticed with some players.
Is the Zoom, because my face.
No, it's not Zoom. It's not Zoom. You didn't get, makeup. You're so stupid. This is something I noticed with a lot of musicians. Maybe you could shed some light on it. I watch people of different levels, and when they play, you see their hands sort of shake like they're not sure. But then when you see real experienced guys, they're very definite in what they're doing.
Right.
But you can see guys that are decent players, but it's like their hands, it's like you hear what they're playing, it'll sound fluid, but their hands are kind of like almost... Like you'll see it like tremble. Like why do musicians do that?
Well, let me ask you a question. I'll answer the question with a question. Have you ever seen a dude in the gym lifting weights that you knew was too heavy for him?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because he was shaking.
He was shaking.
Working extra hard to push up weight. When I was first playing, right? Things that, and even still now, things that I'm uncomfortable playing, things that I challenge to play. I'm gonna exert more energy doing it because I can't do it yet. Mm-hmm. Once I get comfortable with something and I'm familiar with the process, my body, my muscles are familiar with playing a particular chord or playing a particular scale or run or an arpeggio or whatever it is, you yourself relax, which then
that flows into your hands,
right? And it makes the playing easier. Relaxation is like the biggest. And I don't want to sound too like new agey because I don't believe in that garbage. you got to be centered. You got to just be as calm as you can. You know, I play golf, right? Well, I'm starting. Oh,
you play?
To.
You play
I'm golf? Starting to. I'm working with it.
A gospel musician that plays golf.
That's the money sport.
Wow.
That's where the deals are made.
Now y'all know another thing about the gospel guy. He plays golf.
Yeah. So
now what's gonna happen? Everybody gonna want to start playing golf to get
nobody
better.
Nobody wants to copy me. So when I was working on my swing right with this instructor, and he kept telling me to make my legs and my center quiet, meaning don't move so much, like, it's not a lot of motion. Like, you want to be centered, you want to keep your head down, you know, all that jazz, but your legs got to be quiet, not a lot of movement. And it's the same thing with your body when you're playing keys. You got to be, any instrument, really, you know, playing drums, it's all, the more relaxed you are, is the better off you actually be, and the better you'll sound, you know. But a lot of guys are struggling because they're trying to play all this stuff. They got the stuff in their head. They want to get it out there. They're unsure. They're not familiar with the, you know, the process of articulating their ideas. And, you know, it's just like a little dude trying to push 400 pounds. He's not going to be able to do it until he works up that strength to do it.
Confidence too, right?
Sometimes it's confidence too, yeah.
With me, it's confidence.
With you? You got to stop that, man. You got confidence, not arrogance.
Confidence. Yeah, being confident.
You practice, you put in the work, you put in the time, play. Play. The worst thing can happen is it don't sound good, and then you just don't play that no more. that's what I do. I try something, I work something out at home. I like the way, you know, I try to work it into my arsenal. Mm-hmm. And I'll introduce it, and if it don't work, I'll put that back.
Put that back on the back burner.
For a later date. And that's what it is.
On the back burner.
Yeah, man.
All right, cool.
So yeah, I was showing Tim this good chord for you.
What chord is this? What is that?
It's a dominant chord, but so if I'm in E flat, right?
So what is that?
It's an E-flat dominant chord. That's the basis, right? E-flat dominant. There's your seven, right? Right? That's E-flat dominant, basically, right? And I'm going to play, let me break it down. So you got sharp five, right? Then you got, there's a seven again, right?
I break it down from left all the way to right.
Okay, so you got the root.
Root.
Right? At the seven, mm-hmm. Flat seven. Right, mm-hmm. Then you have the flat nine. Mm-hmm. Right, then you got the you can't play it like you know no I don't know
you
anybody can play that so
you
yeah.
Roll it.
Right, so that's the three.
Oh, you playing that?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you got to stretch.
All right, and then you play that. But you got the five. I mean the flat, sharp five. Mm-hmm. Right. Here's a seven again. Right. Here's the flat nine again, right? Then you got a sharp nine, and the five.
Wow.
That's that chord again.
All right. You know, and then I can play that same chord with G. So if I was in like F sharp, right, rather. Right, so same sequence, right? Right. whatever you're gonna play, you know. But
so that's the chord of the day.
I guess. You know.